Hello everyone. In this video, we will learn about constructor overloading. In previous video, we have already learned about constructor, right? In constructor overloading, first is what is constructor overloading? Okay. The constructor overloading can be defined as the concept of having more than one constructor with different parameters so that every constructor can perform a different task. Right. For example, we are taking example of right. Let's see what when we execute this program, what will happen. See, there is a class student, right? This student class has two variable, that is integer and variable name is ID. Then there is a string type variable, that is name. Okay, then there are two constructor. See, constructor name should be same of that class name, right? Our class name is student, then constructor name will be student only. In first constructor, we are not passing any value, any parameter of to that constructor. We are just printing the statement, this is default constructor, right? If you do not use any type of constructor, then Java will create by itself, right? Then we are creating another constructor. That constructor name will also be student, but we are just passing two parameters in that constructor. First is integer type, second word is string type, right? In definition of that constructor, we are just giving the value to the variables of that class, that is in ID and name. ID, the first parameter we are passing, that is I, ID equals to I, name equals to N, the second parameter, that is of string type, we are passing to the constructor, right? Now we are creating an object, that is S of that student class, right? We are just printing default constructor is, and we are well printing the value of ID and name through that object, right? There are two variables, right? ID and name. So when we want to access the variables of that class, we just type object name, that is S dot variable name, that is ID. So if you want to access the ID variable, you just type S dot ID, right? When you want to access the second variable, that is name, you just type the object name, that is S dot variable name, name, that is name. So you simply type S dot name, right? In next statement, we are just finding what will happen if we pass any parameter to that object, right? We have created a new object, that is student, and we are just passing two variables because we have created a second constructor that is accepting parameter as one, first parameter as integer type, and second one is of type string. So we are passing first value, that is 10, that is of integer type, and second value, that is David, that is of string types. You see, whenever you use any time, you pass any variable of string type, you just type that string in double quotes. So we will pass 10 comma David to that object. Okay. Now we will print the value of ID and name through that student object. Okay, to access ID, we will just type student.id. To access name, we will just type student dot variable name, that is name. Okay, now see what will happen if you execute this program. See, output is default constructor values, right? Student ID equals to 0 and student name equals to null, because we did not pass any parameters to that constructor, so it will call the default constructor, and default constructor will print only the default values if we are not passing any values to the object, right? Now, next one is parameterized constructor value. It will printing ID student I equals to 10 and student name equals to David, because we have passed parameters to that object at the time of creation. So it will automatically copy the values 10 and David to 10 to the ID and David value to that name variable, right? So it will print student ID equals to 0 and student name equals to David. Okay. So this is constructor overloading. Hope you will understand constructor overloading with this video. Thank you.